My name is Osei Amponsan, and this is Norfolk State's Center for Material Research Lab. And this lab is actually our Electron Spin Resonance Lab. And today, we're just going to run some materials in our Electron Spin Resonance Spectroscopy. Now, ESR is actually a spectroscopy technique whereby a material is immersed in a strong magnetic field, and then it absorbs electromagnetic radiation. These materials are paramagnetic, that is, they have just one electron spin, and that means your spin is greater than zero. The ESR machine actually automatically calculates the derivative of our sample. The first step here is to turn our water on, and our second step is to turn our heat exchanger on. Then I turn my EMX on. And then finally, we turn our current control on. Now what we have here is our sample cavity. Here we have two bars of magnets here, and this is the cavity that our sample actually goes in. So this sample that we can see at the bottom of our tube, it was a sample that was manufactured specifically for our ESR test. It's a nickel nanorod sample that we're going to go ahead and run in our ESR sample. Now, the sample is going to go into our sample cavity, which we can see in between the two bar magnets. The goal here is try to get our sample to go exactly where the yellow spot is. The yellow spot that we see here is actually where our magnetic radiation goes through our sample. Now what we do is we try to get a visualization as to how far down our tube needs to go to get that spot at the yellow. What we do here is measure exactly how far our sample needs to go down. Now once we get that visualization done, we can go ahead and put our sample in our cavity. And then it should be, our sample should be at that spot. The ESR can run liquid and solid samples. What we have here is a liquid sample, which we can run in our ESR machine. So now that we have our sample in our sample cavity, now we open our software. We go to our file and open up an old file. Now that we have an old file open, we can go ahead and go to our parameter and go to our bridge control. So from here, we can actually tune our signal. Now how we do that is, this is in standby, so we go to tune and we see our signal in this box. And what we're trying to do here is try to get this signal to be in the center of our box. And we can do that by moving our frequency around a little. Once you get a good idea that it's in the middle of the box, you can go to operate. Now the goal here is try to get our AFC, our diode, our operate leveled and calibrated all to be in green. And how we do that is move our frequency. So we can move our frequency, which will control our AFC. And now that we have our AFC, our diode, and our calibrated all in green, we can click the run button and that will actually start recording the signal for our sample. And what we have here is our actual signal. What we can notice is our signal intensity here is very low. We can actually zoom in on our signal by drawing a box using our mouse, and we get a better picture of our signal. Now that we have a signal, we can actually go here, click our file, and save. We can change our file name to text and click the OK button and it will save our file. What we have here is our nickel sample, and what we can conclude from here is our signal tells us our sample is a uniaxial anisotropy sample, meaning it has just one axis. So here we have two samples oriented at different orientations in our sample cavity. Now what we can learn from here is that when you have our sample perpendicular to the applied field, our magnetic response shifts to a lower field. But once you have our sample oriented parallel to our applied magnetic field, our signal shifts to a high field. And that tells us about the magnetic properties of our sample.